In this video, we are going to find out how to dynamically calculate position sizes for buy trades, in this case based on the equity. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Dynamic Buy Position Size. Click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function and the two command lines here. We start with an include statement to include the file trade.mqh. This file comes with MQL5 and we are going to use it to open positions. To do that, we need to create an instance of the class ctrade. We will call that one trade. And inside of the onTick function, we need to calculate a few things. First, we want to calculate the ask price. That is a double value because it's a floating type. The variable name is ask, and we can calculate the ask price by using SymbolInfoDouble. For the current symbol on the chart, we use Symbol_ask, and with normalized double and underscore digits, we automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot for the currency pair on the chart. Afterwards, we want to calculate the equity. The equity is what is left over after we have paid for costs and open trades. And to calculate it, we use AccountInfoDouble. The parameter we use is account_equity, all in capital letters. Let's repeat that for the balance. The account balance is calculated by using AccountInfoDouble. And here is the parameter account_balance. This one is also in capital letters. Afterwards, we are going to calculate the position size. This is a double value. And we use normalizedDouble to cut the results to two digits behind the dot, because when we divide the equity by 100,000, the result might have 6 to 8 digits behind the dot, and that would cause an error, because when we try to open a new position, we would get a journal entry that the position size is wrong, and this is going to prevent that. So let's check the conditions. First, we want to know if the equity is equal or bigger than the balance. The second condition would be, we want to know if the return value for positions total is 0. If that is the case, we don't have any open positions. And that is when we use trade.buy to open a buy trade for the dynamically calculated position size that we have calculated here. Finally, we use the command statement to create an output on the chart that will show us the balance, the equity, and the calculated position size. That's about it. If you don't understand what all the code here does, or if this was too fast for you, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series first. Or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button or press F7. I have an error because this curly bracket is too much. Let's repeat the compilation process. And this time it worked without any errors. If this is true for you, you can click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. please pick the new file simple dynamic bipositionsize.ex5, mark the option for the visual mode, and start a test. The expert advisor is going to open positions, and we can see that the position size is calculated based on the equity. And in this little video, you have learned how to calculate a dynamic position size for buy positions, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.